What non-physical traits do you find highly attractive? A desire to learn and ask questions about all sorts of things. Like what? I hope that didn't turn you on, Ken. Empathy and understanding. Confidence to be different. Thoughtfulness. Introversion. Patience. Intelligence. I have one of those things. Being able to hold interesting conversations. K. Passion. I love listening to someone talk about a hobby they're really into, even, or especially, when I know nothing about it. I might not understand everything they say, but there's just something about watching someone geek out about something they love. The ability to admit when they're wrong. Curious and tolerant. I really enjoy talking about my hobbies or things that pique my interest. Always struggle to find someone to listen though. This is one of my favorite things in the world. I have a friend who went on a date and when he told me about it, he said she talked too much, and I asked if she was all over the place. But no, she just talked a lot about gardening and plants, and I couldn't help but think how awesome that sounded. I find gardening horrible and plants boring, but listening to someone who genuinely cares about something go off about it, is so wonderfully enjoyable. I have an ex-GF who would talk at length about comics and mangas, and while I personally find both rather uninteresting, with some exceptions, I can say in confidence that I know more about the subject than 80% of similarly interested people and thoroughly enjoyed learning about it. I also have a friend who's super into bondage, and one day while we're just talking about nothing, that subject came up, and he launched into a whole tirade about that and foot fetish, to the point that I now have several people believe that I have foot fetish myself. Because in yet another nothing conversation, someone said they just didn't understand why people liked feet, and I was able to explain, to fairly comprehensive extent, why at least some people like feet. Listening to people who care is fantastic. Being really kind with kids and pets. And the elderly. Bit cliche but humor. Cliche but paramount. If you can't laugh with one of your best friends, what are you even doing? Not being afraid of cartoon animals and the ability to make good salad dressing from very cheap ingredients. That's very specific. Also, I'm your soulmate lol. Confidence to stand up for what's right and to be yourself. Besides the bare minimum of compassion and patience, I love someone who can laugh at almost anything. Someone who can have a conversation about touchy subjects without getting offended easily. Someone who doesn't judge me for the things I like, no matter how weird they seem. Someone who encourages me to dress how I want and not care about what others think. Someone who has an open mind and isn't stuck following unreasonable societal expectations. The more I read these, the more I realize that I have a better shot at getting a GF than I think. Strength of character. Compassion, intelligence, kindness. Being smart. Talking about things I don't understand, smiley face. My favorite thing ever is when my boyfriend teaches me about computers. It's seriously the hottest thing ever, like please teach me what thermal paste is and what it means to beat a boss in a game. OMG. I dated a software engineer who would explain things like machine learning to me in a way I could actually understand. The fact that he was smart was hot. That he could explain things simply without being condescending was somehow even hotter. I really like passion and enthusiasm, even if it's something I'm not into. If you're way into a book series one don't like and you start your explanation of things with a bright-eyed, okay, so. Then you have the same base model of soul as I do. If they even have a mild interest in me. Spot on. Anyone willing to have sex with me goes right to the front of the line. Basic common sense. If you're an adult you should know how to survive day-to-day life independently. At least basic hygiene, cooking skills, and financial skills. Accents, specifically Australian, but shushing face. Oi mate, how are you going? Why not join me for some prawns on T Bobby Lotta? Being kind to others. They gotta love frogs. I like people that are hardworking, funny, and kind. Intelligence. Even if it is paired with slight arrogance, it is very attractive to me. But being intelligent and humble is a far more attractive combination. Lots of the other ones here are an absolute must, but also media analysis. I know that sounds pretentious, but being able to pick apart a script or book is very interesting to listen to, and interesting conversation is very important to long-lasting attraction. Sense of humor. I love when someone can make me laugh. Handiness and the know-how to perform multiple skills, tasks. When I detect some sort of dorkiness, holding up conversation, I tend to be rather quiet, reserved, and socially awkward, so oftentimes, I don't have much to say. I hate lulls in conversations because I never know how to recover from them. But I've met people who can basically eliminate lulls in conversation while still allowing me time to respond. Those are some of the best conversations, and I'm trying to learn from those people. Good sense of humor, and being able to laugh at oneself. Curiosity, it keeps conversation interesting when people are always looking into new topics. Humor and not a picky eater. I cannot stand picky eaters. I guess you would sort of hate me then. Speaking on any subject matter to the extent of their ability. I don't mean, hey, I know a lot about this subject. I mean, I'm going to speak about this until there's nothing left for me to say. Some people find it annoying, but holy shit do I love it. Shy but confident, soft in words, heavy in action. Self-discipline. Being able to quote Lot R and the Star Wars prequel trilogy. Did you know it comes in pints because of Obi-Wan? But what about the droid attack on the Wookiees? Patience and understanding are two to name a few. So a nurse fetish? Being considerate and generous. The ability to admit you were wrong. Intelligence and compassion. Being able to respect people's personal space. Not just physically, but also like not calling someone all the time and recognizing when someone just wants to be left alone. Knowledge. Sounds really cheesy, but I mean like how a lawyer, a mechanic or a pharmacist knows, like, a whole other language and gets excited about totally different things from me. There's something so human and amazing about the fact that someone's mind can be wired in a way my mind might never comprehend. A positive perspective and growth mindset. I like this. Being able to admit when you are wrong, and make a heartfelt apology. Honestly, asking for consent and not going against the consent is pretty damn hot. Clinginess. It's a little weird to some people and it doesn't really work with everyone, but I just love when a girl is always texting or calling and super touchy when you're together, etc. I'm not really sure why it's so attractive to me, but it's always just been something that's super appealing to me in a relationship. That's just one guy's opinion though. I'd be fine with slight clinginess, but not to the point where she constantly tracks me, or who I talk to. A healthy sense of humor. Being goofy. There's nothing more wonderful than someone being completely unself-conscious and laughing a snort laugh, or getting absurdly excited about having a muffin for dessert. Work ethic. There is nothing I hate more than laziness. You'd hate me. Why is this marked as spoiler? Being polite. It costs you nothing to tell the receptionist, customer service agent, IT guy on the phone to have a nice day after they talk to you. Yelling at people who work in customer service, waiters, receptionists is pointless. 95% of the time they are trying to help you to the best of their ability. The server didn't cook your food incorrectly. An Irish accent. Most Irish accents will do, and I don't know why that is, but I just love an Irish accent. Irish or Scottish, please. Conscientiousness and humility. People who just pitch in and help without being asked. Back before the pandemic, I loved having dinner parties. My friends, after relaxing with me for a bit after we ate, would just attack the dishes, wipe the table, counters and tidy up with me. I always told them they didn't have to, but they just waved me off and did it anyway. Many hands make the job go faster, and then we'd all go back to chilling out. It made me really appreciate them. Any man or woman, I'm bi, who doesn't treat bugs as a threat but rather as friends and as kind to them, have such sexy personalities. Sarcasm, but not rude sarcasm, but rather, haha, funny inside joke, sarcasm. Work ethic and organization. Didn't realize how important these things were until I met my wife. She's going out of town with family for 4 days, and she had a planner all filled out for me on times I needed to pick up the kids, certain errands to run, and appointments. Also, our experience with distance learning was great because of her organization. All the kids had their own stations in the house with their passwords for every program on a Velcro laminated piece of paper on the inside of their Chromebook. Packets had individual folders for the days of the week. When I'd hear people complain about how hard it was to do distance learning for some parents because they'd lose passwords or something like that, I thanked my wife because it was a breeze to us. Please show her this, if you didn't already. It's so sweet, spontaneous and willing to do pranks with me. Sarah? Good handwriting. OMG this. A fantastic laugh. I love these. A big appetite literally kills me. Yes, it can. Kindness. Honesty. There are a few things. I know some of these things I list may be traits that some people just don't have. Just wanna say, there's nothing wrong with you if you don't have these qualities. This is just what I personally find attractive, and I'm weird as heck. 1. Confidence. Not just self-confidence, but not socially awkward or anxious in general. People who are anxious tend to make me anxious or make me feel like I need to help calm them down. And I just love it when someone who is chill, relaxed, and calm. Somebody who doesn't worry all the time is very attractive to me. I really like somebody who doesn't care too much what people think, and people who are not over the top indecisive. 2. Patience. Somebody who doesn't get irritated or easily upset either. I hate it when parents scream at their kids, or anybody who has a nasty temper. I like somebody who won't let their day be ruined by a few things going wrong. Somebody who can just take the higher ground in an argument, and not let stupid things rile them up. 3. Intelligence. Somebody with a good memory, and at least average intelligence. I love people who think outside the box and come up with inventive ideas. That is super attractive to me when somebody solves a problem in a unique way. Someone who isn't daunted by puzzles, problems, or complications. Somebody who I can play trivia games with, and follow complicated TV shows, and discuss in-depth topics. 4. Respect. Respect for themselves, for me, and for others. Especially someone who respects my family and friends. Someone with self-respect, and somebody who respects me. All I need is a little respect. I just find it super attractive. 5. Masculinity. Not the kind of he-man toxic masculinity. The type of guy who is so secure in his masculinity that he can watch Disney princess movies with me and not be dumb about it. I'm a bit rough around the edges for a girl, and guys who make me feel masculine is a turn-off. I love it when a guy makes me feel feminine and when he's tougher and rougher than me. 6. Adventurous. I love people who are up for anything. I love the kind of people who make a game out of stuff, or try to have fun no matter what we're doing. People who are ready to go do something at the drop of a hat, and don't mind doing something a little risky for the thrill of it. Lastly, things like humor, kindness, gentleness, productive, handy, fun, thrifty, careful, foresight, wisdom, humility, considerate, and positivity are all extremely attractive traits. That was such a dope-ass inspiring insightful answer. Thank you for sharing your enthusiastically authentic point of view. Liking video games.
Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.